Slipknot is easily one of the most recognizable bands in heavy metal history. Dancing the line between brutal and mainstream, the band has gone on to transcend what we know capable of extreme metal, and it all started with their debut back in 1999. This is Frank from Metal Injection counting down 20 facts about Slipknot's debut album that you may not know. Following the band's 1997 demo release, Mate Feed Kill Repeat, the band continued their writing sessions with new vocalist Corey Taylor, and eventually recorded a demo that featured Spit It Out. Well-known producer Ross Robinson loved the intensity of the song so much, he pushed the band to be signed to Roadrunner Records, and kickstarted the career we know today. Slipknot was initially uneasy about having a DJ in the band. However, during a live performance early in the band's career, Sid Wilson attacked Clown and nearly knocked him out during the show, leading them to hire him for his turntable skills as well as his wild nature. Producer Ross Robinson used many unique ways to get the performance he was looking for. Drummer Joey Jordison has stated, "He would take potted plants and throw them at me while I was playing and I'd have to duck them. He made Chris drink 2 gallons of water to where he was totally bloated and on the verge of throwing up just to get a mic'd mallet sound out of his stomach." The version of Spit It Out found on the record is actually the demo version recorded in 1998. Ross Robinson tried to re-record it for the album, but was unable to get the same intensity. They added Sid scratches to the demo, and it's what you hear on the album today. There are a few movie samples found on the album, including the infamous line found on the opening track.
A sexual kick out of it, the whole thing, I think it's sick.
Which was taken from an interview in a Charles Manson documentary. The track Diluted also contains a sample of a man saying, "I haven't got time for the living," which is taken from the cult classic Cemetery Man. And the sample found on Sick is none other than the voice of Al Pacino taken from the blockbuster Carlito's Way. Although the band had gone through numerous lineup changes between the demo and the recording of the self-titled album, the debut features original member Josh Gnar Brainard, who recorded guitars on nearly every song on the album. Josh would wind up leaving the band during the Christmas break, stating there were decisions made that he wasn't particularly happy with. The band returned to the studio a month later with new guitarist Jim Root, who the band knew as Corey's guitar player in his old local band Stone Sour. The tracks Purity and the re-recorded version of Me Inside are the only songs that guitarist Jim Root performs on the album, as he entered the band towards the end of the recording cycle. He was given the black bondage mask of his predecessor, Josh Brainard, but quickly swapped this out for his well-known jester mask, as he felt it was more comfortable and reflective of his personality. Jim's second show ever with the band was Ozzfest, which he described as a nerve-wracking and scary experience. Guitarist Mick Thompson has described the recording session of the album as a nightmarish hell, explaining that they didn't have enough beds for everyone, with no money and no real food. The opening track, 74261700027, gained its title from the shipping barcode found on their 1996 demo, Mate Feed Kill Repeat. These are the same numbers found on the members' jumpsuits throughout the early years, and are meant to remind the band of how they started out. In the early days of Slipknot's live experience, the band had a strange pre-show ritual of whiffing a jar that contained a dead crow. The decaying bird was kept by Clown for years, and the pre-show act was a way for the bandmates to allow death to enter them.
Oh, God.
At the end of the record, you'll find moments of silence, broken by audio of the band discussing a porno they were watching in the studio, before ripping into the hidden track Eeyore. Vocalist Corey Taylor was working at a porn shop before the recording sessions of the album. He returned soon after, as the band had an additional 6 months of getting the album art and packaging together before they ever hit the road. Corey Taylor picked the number 8 because of his childhood obsession, stating, "I was born on the 8th of December. I used to count everything by 8s. I had OCD when I was a kid. I was obsessed with even numbers, but 8 most of all." The cover photo of the band's debut album was shot inside the garage of Clown's parents. Sid Wilson cracked his head open during a warm-up gig for the band's first ever tour on Ozzfest. The incident required him to go to the hospital to receive 16 stitches. One hell of a way to begin the band's first shows to the world. The release of the album was immediately met with controversy surrounding the tracks Frail Limb Nursery and Purity, inspired by a story of a girl named Purity Knight, who was kidnapped and brutally buried alive. The story was believed to be true, but was later found to be a fictitious story published on the web. To prevent any problems, the band removed the two tracks and reissued the release later the same year with the song Me Inside. The dreads found on Corey's early mask were real. He used to pull his dreads through holes in the mask so they come out, but he eventually shaved his head and simply glued the dreads onto it, making it easier to put on while keeping the aesthetic. When the band had decided to go by numbers, there were 8 members in the band at the time, and each received the exact lucky number between 1 and 8 that they asked for, with no argument. When Sid later joined the band, instead of taking the number 9, he claimed, "I am not a number. I am zero." Despite nearly every song on the album finding its way on Slipknot's set list, the track Diluted remains to be a deep cut they have never performed live. Corey Taylor has said in interviews that he is very emotionally attached to the song, which we believe might be a reason it's never been included. Slipknot was bred to be one of the hardest working bands in metal. The band members were together every day for nearly 2.5 years on the record cycle, from recording to touring, going from opening slots to headliner status. Once the cycle was complete, they went straight into work on their 2001 follow-up, Iowa. And that's our list. Please hit the like button and subscribe to Metal Injection for more updates.